Hello everyone, in this video we will make a weather status app in MIT App Inventor. Using this app we can know the live status report of our phone's battery. As you can see here, the app displays the charge level, capacity, voltage, status, temperature, health and much more. So let's start making this app. First, start a new project. Let's name the app Battery Status App. Now we will need to download the engine of the app, I mean the extension. Click the link given in the description to directly go to the download website, or you can search in Google Battery Status Extension for MIT App Inventor. Click the search result from the website puravidaapps.com. Then scroll to the bottom and you will find two files. One will be in AIX format and the other will be in AIA format. We know extensions are always in AIX format. So click the AIX file and the extension will be downloaded within a few seconds. Then go to MIT App Inventor, click on Extensions, Import Extension, choose the extension file or drag and drop it. Click Import and wait some time. Then to add the extension in the app, drag and drop that into the phone screen and it will get added. Let's understand the extension first. It has a total of 12 features or functions, namely capacity, charge counter, current average, current now, energy counter, health, level, plugged, status, technology, temperature and voltage. I have arranged them like this. Level means the percentage of charge the battery has. And capacity also means the same. Voltage means the voltage present in the battery. Status indicates whether the battery is charging or not. Plugged is the type of current charging the battery, which is AC or DC. Temperature is the temperature of the battery. Technology is the type of the battery used in the phone. Charge counter means the charge left in the battery. Current average is the average current flowed in the battery. Current now is the current flowing at present. Energy counter is the energy in the battery or number of electrons. And health means the overall condition of the battery. The app will tell us whether the battery is in good state or in bad state. Now let's design the app. First, drag and drop a vertical arrangement from the layered section into the screen. Then set its height and width to fill parent so that the whole screen is covered. Now drag and drop a label from the user interface section into the vertical arrangement. I want the label text to be at the center of the screen. For that, I will click on the vertical arrangement and set the align horizontal setting to center. Then open the label 1 settings, set the width to fill parent and set the text alignment to center. I will set the font size to 20. Now we will need 12 such labels in the app as there are 12 functions of the extension and I will use them all. But if you want to not use some of the features or functions which you might think unnecessary, then you can make labels according to the total number of functions you would use. To make duplicates, select a label and keep pressing Ctrl+C and Ctrl+V on the keyboard until you make 12 copies of the label. After that, starting from the first label, rename the labels serially one by one like this: Label, Capacity, Voltage, Status, Plugged, Temperature, Technology, Charge Counter, Current Average, Current Now, Energy Counter, and Health. Now let's start blockings in the block section. Click on screen 1 and get screen1.initialize block in the screen. Click on label, drag and attach the set label text to block with the screen initialize block. Now click on typhoon battery, find typhoon battery 1.label and add it with the label text block. Again, As I will use 12 functions of the battery extension, I will make 12 copies of this block by selecting the label.txt block and pressing Ctrl+C and Ctrl+V keys and attach the 12 blocks one by one under the screen1 initialize block. Now serially, I will change the functions in the blocks and match them with each other. If we keep it like this, then the app will display something like this. In here, it is difficult to understand which value is for which function. So, we need to attach a join.txt block with all the label blocks. You can see there are two strings in the join.txt block. We need to attach the typhoon.battery function blocks in the second strings, that is the down ones, like this. Now add blank text boxes in the first strings. Write the function names in the text boxes for each function block like this. And add some spaces after the function names. I am giving 5 spaces. You will get to know the reason of giving spaces when we will test the app. Click on Typhoon Battery 1 and add the block when Typhoon Battery dot changed in the screen. Now we need to duplicate and add all the blocks from screen 1 to typhoon.battery changed block. Here's how we can do that. Click on screen 1.initialize block. Press Ctrl+C and Ctrl+V to duplicate it. Click on the first label block of the duplicated blocks. Drag that to the battery block. And finally delete the single screen 1 block. Finally, the block section is complete. If we now run the app, then all the functions will work and show up correctly. Notice that there are some spaces between the names and the values in the labels. This is because of the spaces we had given earlier in the block section. If we hadn't given the spaces, then it would look too much congested like this. Block section is complete. But the app interface looks normal and is not interesting. So I will try to give the designer section some finishing and final touches to make the app look nicer. You can design it in your taste and in your choice. Okay, so now decoration is complete. Let's now export the app and install it in the phone. Thank you. Okay, so that's how the app works. It can be helpful for many reasons. You can use it to manage your battery perfectly and keep your phone in good condition. If you found the video helpful, then please like it, share it with your friends, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and turn on all notifications to get notified with my newer videos every day. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned, stay safe.